this is the last time I will be appearing before you in this capacity. I'm retiring at the end of this semester. I'm happy to say that my successor, Emmanuel Caramon, has already been engaged, and I'm very happy because he's a wonderful artist, and I hope everyone here will give him your full support, as you've given me. Speaking of support, I want to mention the Robert Smith and Carol Payne Smith Opera Endowment that supports this, as well as the gifts of the family of Bill Apple, my predecessor, and also the Phyllis Rappaport scholarship for our pianists. And also, in case you weren't here for our last production, perhaps you don't know that our pandemic opera, On Call, COVID-19, that we did online a couple of years ago, won the National Opera Association Collegiate Opera Competition. Since that time, we've discovered that we were national finalists for the American Prize. So it's been a very good year. We have had many challenges putting this show together. We discovered that COVID isn't the only possible illness that could stop you from rehearsing for a week. It's going around these days. But we've been working very hard to put the show together. And there are a couple of delightful comedies that probably most of you have never seen before. So please enjoy the show.
Woo!
blushing?
Because it pains me thus to have to listen for the very first time to unkind words you should not think or utter.
Forgive me if I wrong you. I should have known you better. Oh, sweetest of all women,
thank you.
Thank you. I'm in the way. I'll go out then, but I'll come back. But why the umbrella?
It looks like rain. The weather's most unsettled.
A little rain. We're going to have a blizzard.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
this charlatan, this Dr. Miracle, that he can peddle his goods somewhere else. By the way, if a new servant shows up while I'm gone, tell him to wait. I'll be right back.
A new servant?
Yes, my dear girl, you heard me. Someone to replace that rogue I caught sneaking you letters from Captain Silvio. Ah, that quack! That public nuisance! He'll sell no bill of goods to me!
More to it.
Oh,
that you must get ready to receive...
He wasn't ordered to leave. It was a bar simply for his own pleasure.
Veronica!
Yes, dear, I'm listening. And you can hold your tongue for 1 minute.
Thank you. I want you to get ready to
then
receive...
Then how do you explain his uniform?
To hell with the uniform, or you'll listen up, won't you?
Very well, Gloria, interrupting your father.
I'm sorry. Were you saying something?
You must immediately
you don't
prepare... Interview a new
with the yellow stripes, Militia.
Veronica, a new servant that you
have. Furthermore, miss, you're speaking to your stepmother. It is rude to insist upon having the last word. Rude and unladylike.
You can go to the devil, both of you.
You see how you've made him angry.
And you're no better than she is.
I still maintain that they were red. Dragons!
Not again.
When I say yellow.
Inside, there you can jabber to your heart's content. I shall now finish my sentence. I'm going to interview a new servant recommended to me by my friend Julep. The poor devil is waiting in the hallway. Come in, young man. Don't be shy.
At your service, sir.
Strapping young fellow. Perhaps a bit primitive, but that may be all to the good. Step forward. Let's have a look at you. What happened to your eye?
I got into a little discussion with one of those dragoons outside. This is what he gave me. I gave him 13 smash rings and a few broken teeth for good measure.
Well done. How did you start?
I don't need reasons. Never could stand the sight of a soldier just go crazy and start swinging.
Admirable. I can't wait to introduce him to Captain Silvio. But aside from smashing ribs and breaking teeth, what else can you do?
Versatility is my middle name.
Money. Suppose someone, a soldier, for example, offered you a handsome
No, sir, not while I'm guarding the house. If he made a move, I would make a move. If he rolls a fist, I would raise a fist.
That's exactly what I want to hear. You understand it perfectly. So, let me introduce you to my wife and daughter. Veronica, come meet our new servant.
Shut me up inside the closet. What a disgrace! Climb on my breasts. My second husband, my late second husband, was a lawyer.
Lorette, step out.
I can prove that they were red. Penelope showed me
horribly drinking, so I still maintain.
Silence, both of you. Pascal, I present my wife and daughter.
Mademoiselle?
Oh, no. This is my daughter over here.
I'm sorry. I cannot tell which is which.
This man is a killer.
So, Pascal, let's see what you can do. A voice inside tells me it's time for lunch. Lorette, show him how we like the table set.
Yes, Father. Come along, Pascal. We start with the plates.
Lots of energy. I like that.
Really, a clumsy roughneck with only one eye.
Yes, but that one
headstrong girl in love. And he won't take his eyes, or eye, off of you for a second. You hear that, Pascal? I'm leaving my daughter under your watch.
Of course, sir. She couldn't be in safer hands.
Pascal, my jailer.
Come along, dear. Let's go.
What a charming tête-à-tête.
Thank you.
wheat. Ah!
My poor dear husband.
My poor dear father.
My poor dear me.
Here it is, in black and white. Thwarted every step of the way in my hopes pertaining to your daughter, I am forced to take action. A hard-hearted, merciless, subhuman father like yourself does not deserve to live. This very morning, it was my honor and pleasure to slip into your omelet a fatal dose of poison.
Poison?
It is pointless to seek for a remedy. By now, you are well beyond the reach of science. No wonder it tasted so peculiar.
One smell was enough for me. Thank goodness.
Well, why did you just sit there? Run for a doctor. No!
Well, my dear, you read with the letter seven. You are far beyond the reach of science. What you need now is not a doctor, but a lawyer. We need to be quite certain that your will is in order.
To hell with it! I want a doctor! A doctor!
Oh, but your voice, it's already gone. Barely a whisper. Barely a crumb.
Yes. I can see it written on my gravestone. Here lies the former mayor of Padua. Oh, that music. The last trumpet.
Nonsense, Father. It's only that mountebank who succeeded in driving away earlier, the one who calls himself Dr. Miracle.
A miracle! That's what I need! Call him this minute!
Now, dear, let's not get excited. There's an excellent, bona fide doctor in the neighborhood. We'll call for him tomorrow. Assuming the tour still works.
Veronica, call that mountebank, that Dr. Miracle.
Moribundum guaribo.
He can kill you.
See?
Yeah.
Si mihi filiamica.